Audi's nastier-looking new coupe has gained 0.6 inches of width in wheelbase and 2.9 inches of length but lost 132 pounds of mass along the way. Even better, the smaller 2.9-liter twin-turbo V6, the same one found in the Porsche Panamera, produces the same 450 horsepower as before, but gains a thumping 125 pounds to foot of torque over the old V8, bringing the grand total of twist to 442 pounds to foot. As with the previous RS5, you can't get a manual, but this time Audi swaps their signature dual-clutch transmission with an 8-speed torque converter unit from ZF. Behind the wheel. The roads from Toulouse, France to the tiny principality of Andorra offer contrasting extremes, from narrow straight super slob to ultra-technical twisties, an excellent test of the RS5's performance repertoire. The updated cabin presents Audi's typically understated style, with available honeycomb top-stitched leather seats that are supportive but not so tight as to be constricting. Box slats form a continuous extension across the dashboard, and the steering wheel and shifter can be trimmed in either perforated leather or Alcantara. The first thing you'll notice in the RS5 are the low-frequency sounds, which round out the otherwise muted engine noises. Aided by a passive shaker on a metal flap that resonates the windscreen, those nearly subsonic booms and bellows are complemented in sport exhaust-equipped cars with an exhaust valve that comes alive during aggressive driving or when the system is switched to its sportier setting. The sound isn't nearly as raucous as the V8's warble, and some might feel it's too quiet. Then again, however pleasant the engine's subtle bass line is, after a bit of spirited driving you might prefer the system to be switched to normal mode so you can hear your own thoughts.
Don't try this yourself. It's extremely dangerous.